Hi, my name is Mark Needham with StarTree, and in this video, we're going to learn how to get JSON records from Apache Kafka into Apache Pinot. Now, we're going to assume that you've already got a Kafka cluster up and running, and what we'll need to create is an events topic to go with that cluster. And so what you can see on the screen now is we're going to run a Kafka console consumer against that cluster and the events topic so that we can see the records that are coming in there. So at the moment, there is nothing. Now let's go over to Visual Studio Code and have a look at some JSON files that we're going to ingest into Kafka. So we'll start with the first one. The data is pretty much the same, just with different movies. And so you can see if each movie is on an individual line, so it's a JSON lines format file. We have the name of the movie, the release date, the genre, and then some other metadata as well. If we now navigate back to our terminal, let's get that the contents of the first movies file into Kafka. So if we run that command, we can see on the left-hand side, it's now been consumed by Kafka. So it's ready to get into Pinot. So if we come back to Visual Studio Code again, now we're going to have a look at the files that we need to define to create our table. So for a Pinot table, the first thing that we need to define is the schema. And so that's basically what columns are going to be in our table. So you can see we've got a one-to-one mapping. So each of the fields that we saw in the JSON file, it's in here as well. So these are called column names, and then they have a type associated with them as well. So we've got into, we've got a string, and then down the bottom, we've got a timestamp. You'll notice that we've also specified some categories, our field types. We've got dimensions, we've got metrics, and then we've got date times. And so those are like tips to the Pinot optimizer for when it's running queries. Now let's go to the next file. So if we have a look at our table config, first thing to notice is we've specified the type of this table as real-time. And so that's what we need to use. When we're ingesting from a streaming source, we need to make sure it's a real-time table. The name of the table is movies. So that's what we're going to use when we write our queries. And then we reference the schema as well. And then let's go down a bit. If you notice the stream config down here, we first of all say, hey, this is Kafka. We specify where exactly is our Kafka cluster running. So in this case, it's in Docker. So we specify the name of the Docker container. And we need to specify the name of the topic as well. And then the last thing I'd like to point out here is the offset that we're using. So we're passing in a value of smallest, which will mean that it picks the earliest value for each partition in the Kafka topic. So in this case, it's going to be starting from zero. But you can also pass in a value of largest, in which case we'll pick the largest value, or you can pass in a timestamp. Now let's create that table. So if we come over to our terminal and run the add table command, so this add table command is going to create the schema, and then it's going to create the table as well. So if we run that, give it a few seconds, there we go, we've got our table. And now if we come over to our web browser, we've got the Pinot UI running in here, and if we just refresh that, we'll be able to see we've now got a movies table, and if we click on it, we've now got some records in there as well. But what about getting data into Pinot from a Kafka when everything's already running? So let's go back to the terminal and see how we do that. So this time we're going to ingest the data from that second file. So let's run that command. And there we go. So that data we can see on the left-hand side, that data has made its way into Kafka. And if we come back again to our web browser, the Pinot UI, rerun the movies query, and there we go. So we've got data into Pinot that was already in Kafka. We've got data into Pinot as both of the systems were running. And so we're now in a pretty good place. And so at this point, it's now over to you to give this a try with your data and let us know how you get on. We'll see you in the next video.